$46,000 account at $46,000 at $46,000 at $46,000 here at $46,000 here $47,000 $48,000 I say that $48,000 you get $49,000 40 round up 40 50 at 50 you enter 50 51 I've got 52 52 at 52 still in 52 at 53 53 back here in the hall 54,000 55,000 56,000 57,000 58,000 59,000 60,000 61 62 63 64 65 66 67 68 69 70 71 72 73 74 75 76 You sure? One more sometimes gets it. 76 77 78 sometimes doesn't. 78 You still in? No? 78,000 thank you anyway. 78,000 on the telephone with Kathy is selling there. $78,000.
$78,000.
Sorry,
can I come up
with the village number? Thank you.
806. I think that's probably a record for the aggressive auction in Australia, actually, hasn't it? So wonderful. Fantastic buying. Great moving car.
Thank you. Lot number 25 now is the 1971 Morgan James.
Yes, it's a Morgan 4-4-4-seater. For those of you who are in and out why it's called a 4-4, it's not because it has four seats. It's because it's got four wheels and four cylinders. Most Morgans, when they were first born, only had three wheels. And then this is the first production car, so they called it a 4-4. Four-cylinder engine and a wheel in each corner. This is a four-seater, so it's a 4-4-4. Beautifully restored 1975 example. Pleasure to drive, pleasure to look at. Absolutely lovely. I don't, you still get a 4-4, but I don't believe you get a 4-4-4 at all. How beautiful.
I'm glad you said that, not me. Bit of a tongue twister. What a wonderful car. Being very happy to drive that myself. 36,000. We'll start here. 38,000 now. At 38,000. At $38,000 here. 38,000. At 38,000. At 38,000. Looking at steel at the moment. 38,000. At hands went up there, I think, some shades. 38,000 at 38,000 at 38,000 at $38,000 then. Going once, going to 40,000 now. $40,000 here. That's more like it, 40,000 at the back. At $40,000. I will sell it here at $40,000 if there's no eye. At 40,000, bid now or not at all. 40,000 at the back, 40,000. Going once, at 40,000, going twice. Last call then, your lucky night sir, 40,000 to bid on 149. Congratulations.
444, what's 40?
Lot 26 is the Sydney record holding Ford model boat chair today.
This is an absolutely magnificent car. I love record breakers. And this car still holds the record, even after the last 87 years. It was the last car to do the Sydney to Bourke, and the record still exists because soon after the government saw sense and stopped people racing on the open road. It's absolutely magnificent car, a Model A boat tail car, so not looking like a normal Model A, but beautifully done, and a wonderful car with beautiful history, provenance, and a part of Australian social history.
Thank you, fabulous car. And the after Model A, 36,000 is going to start now. 37,000 here, at 37,000. at $37,000, starting low here at $37,000, at $37,000 here, at $37,000, 38 if you like, at $37,000 here, at $37,000, we're all done, at $37,000, going once, going twice, last call, but now I lost all at $38,000 now. Gentlemen here at $38,000, $38,000, $38,000. Yes, I'll sell here at $38,000, if no higher, at $38,000. $38,000 to the gentleman here, going once, twice, last call, $38,000. You, sir, your family, $38,000, bid at 235. Thank you very much. Lot 27, James.
Lot 27, the Uffendale 1928 Austin 7 Special. The first car to cross the start line at the first Australian Grand Prix at Bathurst and held in current ownership for the last 54 years. As late as 1937, the Uffendale still held the lap record at Bathurst for the 750 class with its 747cc engine. And so it was beaten in 1938 by one of our other cars coming up later, so that's quite a nice thing. Wonderful history and prominence with this car. The first car across the start line of the first Australian Grand Prix at Lowderfall. Wonderful documentation comes with this car. It's in beautiful condition. And if you're looking for an historic racer, what a wonderful way to get off the line.
Thank you, James. There it is. Great history for this car. $46,000 starting. $48,000 here, $48,000. At $48,000. At $50,000 now. $50,000. At $50,000 here. $52,000 if you like. At $50,000. I'll pick your $52,000. At $50,000 here. At $50,000. We're all done. At $50,000. At $50,000. All done, all finished then. Going once, going twice, at $50,000 only. Last call then, at $50,000. Pass that one, unsold now. Come and see us afterwards if you're interested. Won't stay unsold for long. James, lot 28.
1951 Jaguar XK120, 3.4 litre, open, two-seater. Wonderful car. Sir William Lyon's design, XK120, the car that's called the 120 because of Gemelli on the motorway in Belgium, they set a record of 120 miles an hour, and that's why the XK is called the XK120. Very, very nice car, drives very well, I'm told. I've had the pleasure of driving it myself. You can see in the photographs and in the catalogue. Has a set of beautiful blue matching luggage, matching the interior. Upholstery comes with its Jaguar Heritage Certificate, a remarkable example of one of Sir William Lyon's finest.
Fabulous, thank you. Thank you, James. And just a Sarah Motors here, this has a four-speed manual gearbox with no overdrive, just make a note of that. And there we are, a true classic, the 51 Jaguar XK120 and 110,000 is going to start here. Start low here at 110. At 115 now. At 115. At 115. At 120 now. At 120. At 120,000. At $120,000 here. At 125. 125. At 125. Here I have 125 on my left. At 125. At 130. At 130 is here at the front of here now. Against you on the telephone. I have been here at 135.
Can you tell us sit down here?
At 135. Still good line here. 135. Yeah, 140 shall I say? 137 and a half, if you like. Take a half bit of that. 137 and a half. 137 and a half. Same for you. 140 now. At 140. Another little half sit. 140, 142 and a half. Less painful that way. One, same for you, 142 and a half. No, you're out at 142,500. Look like you've got a new car. Congratulations, bid at 217. Well done, that was fine.
Sorry?
Lot 29, James.
Yeah.
got some remarkable Jaguars in this sale, as I'm sure we're all aware. And the next one is 1961 Jaguar E-Type Series 1, 3.8 open two-seater, E-Type Jaguar Roadster. This one's a very, very special car. It's a very early model from September 1961, and that's when the swinging 60s really took off. The Mini in this one made England swing, and the great thing about this E-Type Jaguar, of course, is it's a flat floor model, being an early model, highly desirable, highly collectible, and also this car is just the 100th ever E-Type produced, E-Type Roadster produced, should I say. They started at 101, they started at number 1, and this is 850101, and also has been in single family ownership for the last 43 years, and of course comes with it's a Jaguar Heritage Certificate, and a great opportunity for something for over the next 43 years. A beautiful, beautiful motor car, highly desirable, highly collectible, flat floor model.
Here we are, thank you James, what a beautiful car. There it is, lot 29, and 220 cars, and it's going to start here, 220, and 230, and 230, 240, and 240, and 240, at $240,000. At $240,000, at $240,000, at $240,000 only. Looking very, very reasonable here at the moment. At $240,000 here. At $240,000. At $240,000. Take a five if you like. At $240,000 here. Looking like a bargain at the moment. $240,000 here. At $240,000 any higher. At $240,000, all done, all finished, at $240,000 then. You'll have to sell it after, $240,000, come and see us afterwards. Lot number 30, James.
I love good stories, and this is a great feel-good story. Lot 30 and lot 31 come as a pair. They're not being sold as a pair, but they've been living together for the last, I can't quite work it out, 50, 60, 68 years, these two bikes have been moving side by side car to each other. And the first of these has been in single family ownership since 1949. They only built 421 of these bikes. We're offering two of them tonight. It'd be lovely if they could stay together, brother and brother. Brown saddle and black saddle, but here's the opportunity to buy brown saddle. 1939 Harley Davidson, model new, with sidecar, held in single family ownership since 1949, now on sale for the first time in 68 years, one of just 421 bikes of this mark, of this model.
Thank you, James. A great story about building the current owner there in the cabin. If you haven't read it, please do. Great story. Lot 30 is the first, and the pair of 22,000 is going to start their way 22 at 23,000 here, at 23,000 for the first year. $23,000 here, $23,000, $23,000 at $23,000 here, at $23,000, $23,000 at $23,000, $24,000. At $24,000, selling here at $24,000 for the first year, $24,000. At $24,000, I will sell here at $24,000, going once, $25,000, thank you. $25,000. Another one, $26,000. Another one, sir? $27,000. $28,000. You in, sir? $28,000 I've taken here in the front. Get it to you at the back. $28,000 here close to me. Going once. $29,000. Round it up. $30,000. One more here. $30,000 here. $30,000. Shake of the head there at the back at $30,000 then, going once, going twice, your $30,000. Congratulations to the first 30,000 to bid at 215.
Sorry, it just gets better and better because all that one was great. It is. We helped us celebrate the 100th anniversary of Harley Davidson, a company founded in Australia, 100 years of Harley, a company that was founded in 1903. This Harley Davidson was built, was bought by Uncle Bill when it was new. So this has been in the family since 1939. Single family ownership since 1939, the second of the 421 units of the 1939 Harley Davidson model unit sidecar that we offer this evening. This is Black Saddle. Uncle Bill, the owner of both, passed away in 2016. Here is your opportunity to celebrate 100 years of Harley Davidson in Australia with absolutely remarkable life. Never been offered for sale before. Basically, this will be going to the second owner.
That is going to be great to keep the two of them kind together. Anyway, 31, here we go. And 22,000, let's start again with me. And 22,000. At $22,000, 23,000 now. At 23,000. At 23,000. At 23,000. 24,000. In the middle there. 24,000. At 24,000. At 24,000. Are you in? 25,000. 26,000. 30, jump straight to 30. 30, here at the front. 30,000, take the head. $30,000. Going once, going twice. Great story, staying together. $30,000. Thank you.
Short lane together, great stuff. Next up, 132973 Motor Woodsy, 850 El Dorado. Here's your opportunity to get on the Golden Road with this beautiful 850cc Motor Woodsy. Beautiful motorbike, one of my favourites.
Everybody's dream, I would imagine, growing up on a motorbike like this. Lot 32 and $13,000 a half straight away. $13,000 and $13.5. At $13.5 now, $13.5. At £13, $500. At $13.5. At $13.5, $14,000 before you, sorry. At $14,000 here, I took a gentleman's stand. $14,000, $14.5 if you like. 14 and a half here, at 14 and a half off the telephone here. Another one? 15,000 now, at 15,000, at 15,000, 15,500, 15, sure? One more sometimes, get it, 15,500, at 15, when you read it later, 15,500 if you get it, 15,500, no, going once, going twice, last call then, 15,500. Yours to bid a number, what was the, 802, thank you. Lot 33, James.
Lot 33, 1911 Armstrong Whitworth, B3, 15.9 horsepower. We all like a bit more horsepower these days. So this is a pretty powerful motor car for its time. Remember, this car is over 180 years old. We've all heard of Armstrong Sydney, that's the same Armstrong. We've all heard of Whitworth's Currents, nothing to do with those. One of the mere 13 known to support this. We're very lucky to have this fantastic Edwardian brass in the car. It runs very well, I'm told. It's very solidly built, beautifully done, big Australian history, and it's a lovely motor.
Thank you very much,
James. Lot
33, $54,000 last call. Not quite. Come and see us afterwards. Just see what we can do. the option, lot 34.
1932 Swallow Austin 7 Saloon Mark 2. I'm told by the Swallow Register that there's no such thing as Mark 2, but it's the second version of the Swallow. And this is one of the very last films. We have two competing stories from the experts in everything. One says it's the penultimate Swallow ever built. The other person says it's the last Swallow ever built. So we're going with the last Swallow ever built, and I think that's very good. Catalogue sale room notice, this is my mistake, so I have to own up for it. I transposed the wrong number to the engine number. The engine number should be M/28/04, which is the engine number stamped on the block, which is the engine that this wonderful motor car was originally delivered with in 1936. My apologies for that mistake. This has to be one of the prettiest motor cars anywhere ever seen. It's just a little jewel, it's a beautiful thing. You can put it in the living room, you can probably take it upstairs and put it in the bedroom. It still runs and drives beautifully. It's got all its accoutrements, including its ladies' cosmetic case. It's wonderful bits and bobs all over. Not the original colour, but this was period colour, and it's absolutely beautiful. It's cherry and cream. It's got a remarkable history. The original tax disc from 1932 is still in the windscreen with the car. It's absolutely marvellous. All of the details are there. It's listed in all of the historic books. Maybe think I'm talking about the next car. I haven't got there yet. This car still. It's listed in all the source books, all the material. It's a very, very much sought after car. They're starting to fetch big money. It's a huge opportunity to come out of the car. Comes out of a very important collection here in Melbourne. It's been in current ownership with that owner for the last 17 years. And it's got wonderful history, provenance. There is nothing really that can be faulted about this car. Just I shouldn't really use the word perfect, but it's a perfect example.
Thank you, James. You're right to talk it up. It is a beautiful car and well priced here too. $32,000. Oh, there's a sale notice here on the screen. Thank you very much. So $32,000 is going to start here, very low here. $32,000. We'll watch it go. $32,000 is starting. $34,000 here on the telephone. $34,000 here. At $34,000. At $34,000 here. At $34,000 here. Where's it at? $34,000. At 36,000, over in the far right there, 36,000. At 36,000, $38,000
here,
$38,000.
$40,000.
At
$40,000
here. At
$40,000
here. This car, $42,000. At $42,000.
Four
of them,
all Jaguars.
At $42,000 here, $42,000. At
$42,000. Signed by Sir William Lyons before he introduced Jaguars. The Swallow Sidecar Company took an Austin 7 chassis and put this remarkable body, designed by one of Sir William Lyons' young apprentices. It's really an amazing thing. This is the beginning of Jaguar, if you like. And this is the car that Sir William Lyons designed. And then post-war, of course, then we come on to the XK120s and cars like that. On an Austin 7 Swallow body, chassis with a Sir William Lyons Swallow body. And, you know, still got its original British plates. These plates were on the car when it was first registered in 1932. These are the pictures we have of the car in 1932. Wearing these same plates. And should I keep going or?
No, I think they're going to have to take that. That's very good. Very good. Unfortunately, somebody who was terribly keen to be from a far-flung country on the other side of the world, we can't get back. We managed to get back, we're having connection problems. Maybe he's driving in the other Swallow.
So 1932, Swallow Austin 7 Saloon. We're back online.
We're here. Thanks, James. So we have $42,000. $43,000, worth the effort, $43,000, sorry for the delay, ladies and gentlemen. $43,000, still in, $43,000, no, $43,000 here. So $44,000 you get a hit. $44,000, $45,000. Before you, 45, when was that? 46, thank you. Back to the original bidding here, 46,000, thank you. 46,000. Hensberg, 47,000. 47,000. On the telephone here, thank you anyway. 47,000. 47,000. With Hensberg here, 47,000. 48,000. Wherever that is, I can't see. 48,000, thank you. 48,000. Back to here. 48,000. $48,000 here. Are you in? At $48,000. $48,000 the bidder here in the room at $48,000. Come against you now then at $49,000. Back in the original bidder again. $50,000 here. $50,000 here. At $50,000 going once. $51,000 if you like. At $50,000 going once, going twice. Last call, or not at all, at $51,000. Your sir, $51,000. It's a lovely car. Come to this original talk as well. Well, if you could talk for 10 minutes on the last car, James. I'll hand over to 36, lot number 35, Brian, to you now.
Well, not 35, we're just waiting on the telephone bit of the room, I'm going to skip this one out for a little bit. Not 35, I think a lot of people are very, very interested in this car, of course, so they should be. One of the most famous races, Chad Binning over here already, I've got him this one, one of the most famous racing cars of all time. And how apt it is that I am able to offer a Jaguar D-Type in this, the 60th anniversary of the 1957 Le Mans win, where Jaguar D-Types came first, second, third, fourth, sixth, in Le Mans, and really made the reputation of Jaguar. Of course, they'd already won in 1956. The Jaguar D-Type won in that ill-fated day. And that car last year in auction in the United States sold for $21.8 million. The car that we have on offer has a really, really interesting, unbroken history and provenance. It never actually raced Le Mans, it never won Le Mans, it did some remarkable things. The 1955 Jaguar G-Type, chassis number XKD510, is without doubt the most important, or one of the, I should not say that, but the most important car ever to be offered for auction here in Australia. It's a truly international car, owned by Duncan Hamilton at one stage. Duncan Hamilton had won Le Mans in 1953, driving a predecessor, a C-Type. He owned two of these cars at one time. The other car, we've got a wonderful picture in the catalogue of Duncan Hamilton, one of the great racing drivers of all time, driving the other car, being led down the straight by his friend in this car, XKD 510. That was at the Dakar Grand Prix in 1957 in Senegal. And although we don't have a Grand Prix in West Africa anymore, at the time, that was one of the most important races on the calendar, not least because the Senegal, the Dakar Grand Prix track, was the fastest track in the world. Duncan Hamilton, in his autobiography, Touch Wood, says that with special gearing, they timed this very motor car, XKD 510, down the back straight at over 200 miles an hour. This is 60 years ago. Not only is it an exceptionally fast car, an exceptionally sought-after car, it's also a very, very rare motor car. They didn't build very many of these. Jaguar raced them themselves, and they also sold them to privateers, such as Duncan Hamilton, such as Jerry Ashmore, who also owned this car at one stage, another Formula One driver who embraced this car with success. We've got beautiful pictures of Jerry Ashmore, a driver who was noted for his sliding ability, just slipping this car round the bend at Goodwood and at Silverstone. The car later came to Singapore and then on to Australia, where at one stage the car was owned by our own Bib Stillwell, again, one of the great racing Australian racing drivers. Bib was also the owner of two. He owned one D-Type in his early days, and this car he owned when he was president of Learjet. He was living in the United States at the time, and again, this car has a remarkable record of historic racing at places like Laguna Seca. The great thing about it is it ticks all the boxes. It's very, very rare. You can see from the photographs and those of you who've seen the car itself, it's incredibly beautiful and desirable. It's in remarkable condition. It has excellent history of provenance, continuous history, great names associated with the car, Duncan Hamilton, Jerry Ashmore, Bib Stillwell et al. It's also in remarkable condition. It ticks every box, and for this reason, it's not a cheap motor car. But we think a very, very good value for money motor car. Our estimates is 7 or 8 billion, which, if we achieve something in that region, will make this undoubtedly the most expensive vehicle ever sold at auction in Australia, not only in Australia, but also in the Southern Hemisphere. And I believe it would also make it the most expensive item ever sold at auction, apart from real estate. Painting, jewellery, wine, whatever. So without further ado, I've said pretty much all there is to say. I'll hand over to Paul to auction the 1955 Jaguar D-Type chassis number XKD510.
Thank you very much, James. And I'm delighted to be able to, on behalf of the vendor, start the bidding below our estimate at a very sensible, conservative level, and I'm going to be starting this amazing car at $5.2 million. I have interest in absentee, with me I have interest on the phone and on the internet. So we're going to start at $5.2 million, at $5.2 million, at $5.3 million, at $5.3 million, at $5.4 million, at $5.4 million, at $5.4 million. At 5.4, at 5.4, 5.5, at 5.5, at 5.5, at 5.5 million. You're bidding on the phone. At 5.5 million, at $5.5 million, at $5.5 million. We all done? All finished? At $5.5 million, last call then at 5.5. I'm going to refer this bid at $5.5 million and take it to the vendor and hope to have good news for you at 5.5 million, last call. Thank you, 5.5 million. Permission to say I'm referred at 5.5 million. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, James.
We have a very, very exciting motor car and wonderful country in this history. We move on now to lot 36, 1934 MG Q-Type. And this is another car with remarkable history of provenance. Delivered new in Australia in 1934 to Cess Warren. Owned and driven by Herbert Bartlett. Owned and won stage by the awful Jumbo Goddard. One of just 8 motor cars Q-Type ever built. This is car number 7. Fabulous provenance of history. This held the lap record at Bathurst for 747cc class in 1938, and in the big blue Bathurst that would hold the record briefly, no doubt it was the enormous Zoller supercharger which gave it that extra point.
Thank you very much, James. There it is, lot 36. Wonderful car, as you say. Been lots of interest in this for the through the viewing, Motor Classic here and prior, and I'm going to start bidding here at $350,000 here at $350,000. at 350, at 350, 360 now, at 360, at $360,000 here, 370 if you like, at $360,000 here, at $360,000 here, in, at 360. At 370 now, at 370,000, at 370,000, at 375 if you like on the telephone, at $370,000 here, at $370,000 you in, at $370,000, at $370,000 all out there, at $370,000 going once, going twice, last call at $370,000. You didn't count at $370,000. All done then. Last call, bid now or not at all at $370,000. Thinking about it, wait, can't wait too long for the gavel is about to fall. $370,000. Do you want it or not at $370,000? No? Last call then. Come and see us afterwards. We'll talk afterwards just below the door. Thank you very much. Lot number 37 is the 1970 Maserati James.
Yes, after two fabulous race cars, we've got two fabulous Italians, two fantastic Maserati motor cars. The first 1970 Maserati Gibbon 4.7, matching numbers car, beautiful design, chassis number 1470. This is an original factory right-hand drive, manual transmission car, sold new to Australia on the 19th of January 1970. The original interior, the back interior, we still believe is original, though it has changed from its original yellow paintwork and is now presented in red. So 1970, Australia delivered, right-hand drive manual, Maserati Ghibli 4.7, highly desirable, highly sought after.
Thank you, James. And 140,000 is going to start. 140,000. At 145,000. At 145,000. At 150 if you like, at 145,000, at 145,000, at 145 looking very reasonable here, at 145, at 145,000, at 145,000, at $145,000 any higher here, at $145,000, all done, at $145,000, at 145 going once, going twice, at $145,000, all finished. At 145, last call. That one's on top. 145,000, come and see us.
The next two Maserati is lot number 38, 1969 Maserati Gibbon 4.9. Like the previous car, it's originally as 4.7, but it has been loaded right hand drive, given a 4.9 litre engine and spec'd up to SS specification. So 1969 Maserati Gibbon 4.9 litre, in lovely condition, red. This one is, so you make sure you differentiate, has the light tan interior, the other one with the black interior. So those of you who are on number one, it's the second of these superb Maserati Gibbons. Powerful, fast, efficient, comfortable, one of the greatest GT cars of all time.
Thank you, late 60s Maserati 4.9 there it is, and 200,000 will start here, I go to 5. At 200,000 will start, at 200,000, at 205, now, 205, at 205, at 205, at $205,000, at $205,000 here, at $205,000, all done, at $205,000, 210 for you if you like. At $205,000 here, any higher. At $205,000 going once, twice, last call at $205,000. Been now, not at all, at $205,000. Same way, Sally. See us up. Lot 39, that was the start cars here.
Third car, it's taken to Lake Paul Watson. This is an amazing vehicle, another amazing vehicle. sports racing car. The guy who originally owned this, Patrick Abbott, everything. He was good looking, looks a bit like Jimmy Dean in the photographs. His mum and dad owned Woolworths, so he had a lot to spend. And this last remember was a very, very lucky man. So originally owned by Lance Remembo, who raced this car. Lance went on later to find the Scarab Racing team, which you've all heard of in the United States. Really, really nice motor car. FIA historic technical passport. Pretty sure you can get invited to all sorts of places if you want to race this car in historic racing. Beautiful looking thing, lovely outfitted body. I think the Lance Remembo.
There it is, lot 39, thank you, and 300 fast is going to start here at 300 fast. We're going 10 at 310 now, at 310,000, at 310, at $310,000 here, at 320, at 320, at 320,000, at 320, at 320,000 here, at $320,000 here, at 320, at $320,000 any higher. At $320,000 here, at 320, 325 if you like, 320 at the moment, at 320,000, at $320,000 going once, going twice, at $320,000, all done, finished at 320, thank you.
Lot 40, 1967, that's plus two. Car in remarkable condition, really pretty little thing, beautifully presented, light, but well, almost as light as Colin Chapman said, simplified,
and I think
this is a perfect example of Colin Chapman's ethos, high revving, fast engine, lightweight body, pinpoint steering, in lovely condition. I want to be the Avengers in this one.
Thank you, James. Lot 40, there it is, beautiful car. 1967 Lotus Elan, and I'm going to start the bidding here with interest at $36,000 with me. $36,000 started here. $36,000. At $36,000 with me, $38,000. Thank you, Standard. At $38,000 in red here, $38,000. At $38,000, gentlemen, red here, $38,000. At $40,000 is with me. Back with the absentee bidder here. At 40, is that a bid? At $40,000 here. At $40,000 bids here. At 40, thanks you, sir. At $40,000 bids here. $42,000. Source this bid at $42,000. At $42,000. You're bidding on the phone here. $42,000. At $42,000. On the market, selling $42,000. Going once, going twice. Last football bid now, or not at all. At $42,000 selling. Congratulations, your customer. $42,000. Tiffidel 156.
Lot 41, 1958, this is the Jaguar Novelty replica reconstruction. Really very, very interesting motor car. An application for FIA historic technical passport has been made for this car, which would enable this car to be currently under review by the Confederation of Australian Motorsport. We can't say whether we'll get that or not, but we're pleased to advise that all insurance fees, all necessary fees to receive that historic technical passport have been passed to CAMS. So that's looking very, very positive. So that's a bonus if that comes through. But this legendary replica reconstruction is a very, very sympathetic adherence to the original motor car, the legendary Mr. Jaguar Novelty, and a remarkably fine, fast car presented in excellent condition.
Thank you, James. Lot 41, there it is, and 200,000 to start here. 200,000. We're going five for 200, 205 now. At 205, at 205,000, at $205,000 here, 210, at 210, gentlemen, bid here. Into the column here, I've got you at 210,000, thank you. 210. At $210,000. Waiting to connect here. We have 210 standing in here at the moment, Robbie. 210. And it's 215 if you like. At 210, 215 if you like.
foul was done by one of Australia's finest technicians, John Peake.
Thank you. $210,000 I have here. The bids here standing here, $210,000, going once, $210,000, twice, last call at $210,000. Bid now or not at all at $210,000 for bids here. I'll refer that to you, sir. $210,000, the highest bid, conditional sale. The bidder, $205,000. Thank you. $210,000. We'll let you know after the auction as the highest bidder. Thank you.
Lot 42, 1964 Alvis TE21 Series 3 Drophead Coupe by Clark Ward. Notice I said coupe, not coupe. Very, very English boat car this, and an absolutely beautiful example. Really very, very pretty car indeed. A gentleman's car. I think Prince Philip had one when he was a younger man. Sold for £154,000 sterling, which works out at about just over $250,000. Highly desirable, highly sought after, very, very sophisticated, very, very stylish, and absolute gem.
Thank you, James. And $120,000 is going to start here. At $120,000, I have here. At $120,000, absolutely bidding here at $120,000. At $120,000, we'll start. At $120,000. At $120,000, any higher. At $120,000. At $120,000 here. At $120,000. At $125,000 now. At $125,000. At $125,000. At $125,000. At $125,000 here. At $125,000 here. We all done. At $125,000. Looks very reasonable here. At $125,000 going once. Going twice. Last call at $125,000. We'll speak to the underbidders. Sold, unsold now. Will be sold tomorrow. Lot 43, James.
1961 Bentley S2, another example, very authentic, delivered, still painted in original delivery colours of dark grey and light grey. I've forgotten the exact Bentley specification. Still has its original light grey, dove grey Bentley interior. A very, very nice motor car. You can pull up outside the Royal Exhibition Building with this, and I don't think anybody would be ashamed of you. I think it's the Queen of England. When you arrive, you'll be put in the back seat of this. She'd be very, very happy with it. Lovely example, very well maintained, very, very nice motor.
There we are, thank you very much. Lot 43, and 38,000 is going to start here. 38,000, at 38,000 here. At 38, 39,000. At 40,000. At 40,000. 42 if you like. At $40,000 here. At 40,000. At $40,000 here. 42 if you like. At $40,000 here now. At $40,000. At $40,000 for the Bentley, looking reasonable here. $40,000 here. At $40,000. Submitting on the phones. At $40,000. At $40,000 going once. Going twice. Last call then. Bid now, not at all. At $40,000. Last call. Lot 44, James.